Thank you. Thank you. We take part in.
I would want to encourage you, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. God has more in store for you than you can ever imagine. So, whatever your heart finds to do, do it well and shine out there. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are before you this morning. We thank you, we honor you and worship you for your care, your protection, and for your love. Thank you, Lord, for guests that have come to this institution for this graduation ceremony. We thank you for the peers and all the guests that have come, that they have come to witness and even make it possible for these, our graduates, to, and others who are watching, to bring to a culmination work that started many, many, many years ago. So we thank you as a community of the Nyeri Polytechnic that, Lord, today we can witness young people who have worked hard under and being helped by their trainers here, and they have succeeded. So, Lord, we pray that as we start this the occasion, that you will come and be with us, and that it will go on well. And we pray for them that even as they come to the end in this institution, that it will be a new beginning. And that beginning, you will continue to work with them and help them in all that they do. So that, Lord, the skills and knowledge that they have gained from this institution will be used to serve this great nation, and that they can also shine and know values that are lasting so that they can do things well. We thank you for each one of them. And as they go out, we pray that you will continue to lead them. So, Lord, we release ourselves to you, that you come and help us and give us the strength to do this work, and all shall go well. We praise you and honor you, for this is our humble prayer of faith in Jesus' name.
Amen. Mr. Secretary, the Department of Vocational and Technical Training, the Director Tibet, Chairman and members of the Council, the Chief Principal, senior government officials present, all the class principals, parents and guardians, graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to the Nyeri National Polytechnic for the third graduation ceremony. Graduation. Thank you.
By virtue of the authority vested on me by the Tibet Act No. 29 of 2013 and the Nyeri National Polytechnic Order No. 91 of 2016, I hereby declare this congregation and the proceeding legally constituted. Thank you.
Chief guest, this time now we are going to have a brief statement. In the sake of time, we'll just a few minutes, and it will be presented by the Nyeri Polytechnic Mwoboko Dance Group. Karibuni. The Mwoboko Dance, which was played in the old days when there were celebrations, big celebrations like this. Karibuni sana.
Yeah.
Of the help loans and bursaries to ease the burden on our parents. My fellow graduates, I wish you all the best as you endeavor to transform your lives and those of others through the skills you have acquired. Once again, congratulations and God bless you.
Okay, thank you for that presentation. Chief guest, I'm going to invite the chief principal to give her speech. Thank you.
I want to take this opportunity first to start by congratulating the Nyeri National Polytechnic for this third graduation ceremony. I want to thank the chief principal. It's a while I've been here. The place looks beautiful. Let's clap for this place. This is great work of the board. I want to thank the chairman of the board, of the council, the entire council and the principal for good work. I want to pass the message to the graduates of today that this world is waiting for you. As we have watched the dancing here, we are waiting for you to solve all our problems as a country, and not only this country, but the world. Thank you so much, and God bless you.
Yes. Thank you, Madam Chair. It is with great joy that I welcome you all to our third graduation ceremony. I wish to express our gratitude to all of you for honoring our invitation and blessing this occasion. Chief guest, I thank you most sincerely for finding time out of your busy schedule and joining us as we celebrate the hard work of 2,853 graduates. I'm aware, Madam PS, you are very passionate about TVET, and you have been consistently supporting this institution. Thank you, Madam. Chief guest, the graduates we are releasing today, they have met all the requirements for the award of higher diploma, diploma, clerk, artisan certificate in NEC, NITA, CASNEP, TVET CEDAC, ICDL, and Cisco courses. Madam PS, we believe the competencies that they have acquired here will assist them to bridge the gap in the industry. We have prepared them well, and I'm sure you are ready for that. Can you confirm it?
Yes.
Graduates, can you confirm that you are ready?
Yes.
Chief guest, I take this opportunity to congratulate our graduates today for their achievements in their respective areas of specialization. I recognize the effort made by the trainers and the rest of the staff in helping the trainees to be where they are today. And kindly, I want to request the members of staff of the Nyeri National Polytechnic to be upstanding and wave to the guests. Wherever you are. Okay, thank you, you can sit. Madam PS, with the elevation of the to the National Polytechnic status, registered tremendous growth in both infrastructure and trainee population. Currently, our trainee population starts at 7,345, of which 3,900 are male and 3,414 are female. Most of those students, or all of them, they are enrolled in the engineering courses, others in business-related courses, applied sciences, hospitality, liberal studies, and fashion design and garment making. The growth of the enrollment is a result of the changing perception of the society as far as TVET institutions are concerned. Lately, Madam P.S., we have witnessed a number of trainees opting to enroll in TVET courses and forfeiting their admission to universities. I think we thank God for that. Secondly, the provision of government capitation to all the TVET trainees, the help loan and bursaries, has made the TVET accessible. Otherwise, many of them will not get the fees to come here for the training. So we sincerely thank the government for that. Our chief guest, in our endeavor to meet the needs of the industry, the Polytechnic has partnered with various organizations. They have been sponsoring the trainees here for short courses, more so in CBET. And I want to recognize our partners, GIZ, KCB Foundation, Kenha, SICAN, and also Equity, we have the Wings to Fly. Madam Chief Guest, since 2016, the Council of Nyeri National Polytechnic constructed a dairy processing training plant, and we received the state-of-art equipment in dairy processing from our Canadian partners. And we are sincerely grateful to the government for that arrangement. As the curtains come down on KFF this year, that is when the contract is ending, I'm also happy to report that we are also participating in the Young African Works, and this is sponsored and funded by the MasterCard. And we also thank the government for that arrangement. The deliverables from this project of Young African Works is the implementation of the CBET curriculum and also the development of new curriculum, and with a lot of bias in the dairy processing in value addition. Madam Chief Guest, the Polytechnic is in the process of operationalizing its legal order number 91 of 2016. I want to appreciate TVET CEDAC because when we wrote to them, they approved and they allowed us to use 18 of their curriculum and also the occupational standards. In other words, Madam CPS, we are only waiting now for the KNQA to accredit the Nyeri National Polytechnic as a qualification awarding institution. Graduates, aren't you happy?
Yeah.
Very soon. We have admitted 629 trainees under the NNP program. So very soon, Madam P.S., we shall be calling you when they will be graduating. And this is an achievement. So can we applaud the management of this institution? I also want to thank the trainers. They have worked day and night for us to launch that program. In conclusion, because I don't want to take a lot of time, to my dear graduates, as we celebrate your accomplishment today, I want to challenge you to continue your quest for knowledge and skills and to discover your own unique way to contribute to this society. Thank you and God bless you. I want the chair of the council, Mr. Getir, please.
You are the chief guest, Dr. Margaret W. Mwakima, PhD, DD, CBS, Principal Secretary, State Department for Vocational and Technical Training, the Director of TFET, members of the Council, senior government officials, TFET principals, parents, graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Chief guest, I wish to welcome you and all invited guests to the third graduation ceremony as we celebrate the academic journey of our 2,853 graduates. Before I continue with my brief remarks, allow me to introduce the members of the Governing Council of the Nyeri National Polytechnic. And I will request them that as I read their name, they stand up and wave to this congregation. Madam Grace Bruno, member of the council, remain standing. Madam Evelyn Anupi, council member. Dr. Victor Muyembe, council member, and also serves as the chairman of Finance Resource Mobilization Committee. Reverend Julia Mora Mwangi, council member, and also serves as academic and research chair of that committee. Mr. Joseph Wajohi Muhota, council member, who also serves as the chair of Audit, Risk, and the Compliance Committee. Madam Jane Mugure, council member. Dr. Maureen Chesrek, council member. And our ever hard-working chief principal, Anne Mwangi, who serves as the secretary of the board. Thank you. You may sit down. I appreciate that this achievement that we have witnessed today has come not just on a silver platter, but we have encountered several challenges as individuals already alluded to by the chief principal. This includes, among others, the establishment of three working committees of the council, Audit, Risk, and the Compliance Committee, Finance, Resource Mobilization Committee, and Academic and the Research Committee. In addition, the council charter was developed by the council. Other key policies have been developed also. The current strategic plan, which we participated very, very actively in developing, is expiring in June this year. And the council is in the process of developing the new plan for the period 2022-2027. One of the major challenges has been COVID-19 pandemic. And as you know, this graduation ceremony ought to have taken place 2 years ago. But this was not possible because of the pandemic. It disrupted academic calendar, but also caused disorientation and uncertainty among our trainees. The trainees were not spared, and most of them are now here celebrating this great day of their graduation. Chief guest, we did a number of activities which I will not need to go through here in trying to mitigate against the pandemic. The council also, in terms of infrastructure, expanded mechanical workshop block by adding an extra floor to accommodate tuition rooms and offices. The Polytechnic identified recently that because of the big numbers that we have registered, that when the trainees are getting out of the gate, they risked being run over by vehicles passing on the road next to the gate. We therefore, as a council, proposed that we construct a pedestrian walkway along our fence, and this has alleviated that risk. We wish to thank you, Madam Chief Guest, for allowing us and approving our request that we undertake that work. The Polytechnic is also aware that there are constitutional requirements with regard to discrimination and the need of ensuring easy accessibility to all facilities by all, both trainees, visitors, and also members of staff. In an attempt to align ourselves to this requirement, the Polytechnic pulled down the stairs leading to the administration block and constructed a spacious ramp. The Polytechnic is constructing a hospitality complex at a cost of 135 million, which will house training kitchens, restaurants, housekeeping units, tuition rooms, and offices. Guests, we wish to thank you most profoundly again for giving approval that the construction be restarted, and even for officially laying the foundation stone area this morning. Chief guests, besides infrastructural improvement, the council is also committed to ensuring that the training needs are met. While the Ministry of Education has employed 143 trainers at a public service commission, the council has employed 114 trainers in various departments on contract basis. This has led to huge wage bill for the council. We appreciate the Ministry of Education for providing more than half of our human resource needs, and I further request your ministry to consider hiring more trainers for the Polytechnic to ease this burden. As I conclude, I wish to address our graduates. You have received immense support from your parents and the guardians, which has brought you this far. You have also been equipped with skills, knowledge, and the attitudes, firstly to transform you as individuals, and secondly to transform the society. It is against this background that your worth will be measured. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Congratulations, and may God bless you richly. The County Director Tivet to make his remarks, and then invite Director of Tivet.
Appreciate our chairman with a clap. Our chief guest, Dr. Margaret Mwakima, Director of TVET, the Chairman of the Council, the Secretary of the Council, members of the Council, senior government officials invited today, our CATI principals, trainers, trainees, parents, graduates, guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I want to take this opportunity to thank our peers for accepting our invitation to come and officiate this function. Thank you so much, madam. You have taken a lot of time to come here. We are very much grateful for that good gesture. I want to say that I'm Charles Nyota. I'm the county director of TVET in this region. I want to thank our peers for according me that opportunity to serve in this region. I want to tell you, madam, that this region, we have a very supportive TVET system. I'm in charge of ensuring implementation of all TVET programs is done. So I want to say and report back to you that this region, people are working very hard, and we are very grateful to the management of this great institution for organizing the graduation ceremony, where we have come to celebrate you graduates for working so hard, and now we are giving you the power to go and serve your country. I don't want to talk a lot. I just want to say that we are very grateful for the support we have been receiving from the government in this region. This is our greatest institution, which has acted as the mentor and the father and mother of all other small institutions. And we are so grateful to our principal, who has a big heart, for supporting the small institutions in very many ways. So I want to say thank you so much for Nyeri Polytechnic for supporting the young institution. Today, we have our director, TVET, who is here and is my boss. I don't want to talk a lot. I just want to thank each and every member who has attended this function and tell you that TVET is the way to go. TVET is about transformation. Let us ensure that we mob all the young people in the village, our parents, and we bring them to TVET system so that they can better their life. I'm so grateful, and I wish you well as you go out to work. And as a parent, I urge you to ensure that you ensure you take care of yourself. Remember, your body is very important because it's the one that used to work. So ensure you protect your body against drugs and substance abuse so that you're energetic and strong so that you can serve your country. Please ensure you don't spoil your body. Ni hekalu ya Mungu kama vile tulivyoambiwa. So make sure you keep strong so that you'll be very, very useful to our society. So with those few remarks, I want to invite my director to come and give you the advice that you require to move ahead. Welcome, Director Technical Education.
Our chief guest, Principal Secretary, State Department of Vocational and Technical Training, Chairman and the Chairman of the Governing Council and the members, CATI principals present, members of the staff of Nyeri National Polytechnic, all the graduates present here and those watching online, all the Nyeri National Polytechnic family, parents and guardians, all invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I wish to welcome all of you to the third graduation of Nyeri National Polytechnic. I take this opportunity to thank the government for TVET development, which have seen national polytechnics increasing from 2 to current 12 and a technical trainers college. All the stakeholders of Nyeri National Polytechnic, thank you for ensuring its success since it was upgraded to a national polytechnic status. To all the parents and graduates and guardians and sponsors, who are present in this graduation ceremony, we urge you to be our ambassadors of Tibet, which is having tremendous positive effect of the youth of this country. To the graduates, I wish to congratulate you for the efforts that you have made to ensure that you have marched victorious, and it is you that we are celebrating this day. You are expected to join the Kenyan force either as employers or job creators. Whatever you find yourself, you must ensure that you do not despise the humble beginning. That is, start with what is on offer without minding how much the salary is, and this is the way you'll manage to climb to the top eventually. Besides this, the TVET progression pathway allows you to further your education to the highest levels possible. I pray to God to be with you, lead you, bless your path, and give you enough grace to succeed, for success. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my humble duty to welcome our County Commissioner, Nyeri County. Welcome.
Thank you very much, our PS, Madam Margaret Mokima. My colleague, Mr. Tiptemei, the principal for this college, my colleagues, the curate, good morning. Godfather, I want to invite my colleague, Mr. Tiptemei, who was once my boss here, to say a word, then I will proceed. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Bwana County Commissioner. Our chief guest today, our Principal Secretary, Dr. Margaret Mokima, the County Commissioner and the security team of Nyeri County, the Chair of the Council and members of the Council, the Principal of this institution and her administration, the CATI chair and the members of CATI present, senior government officials, the county director, TVET in this region, parents, graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Madam Governor, I am this institution. And in 2019, I was the county commissioner in this institution. In this county. And I worked very closely with the principal of this institution. And I can assure you, what you see in this institution is a reflection of our administration. I can testify that she is hands-on administrator, and I think you can also see the members of CATI who have attended a function today. I want to believe they also have a lot of confidence and trust in her. Madam Principal and your team, I want to congratulate you. This place is a very good place. It is very impressive. And we are happy to be here. And I'm very sure your colleagues here have seen that you set the bar so high for them. So you guys, be assured that when we come to your institutions, we will be looking at your institution and comparing with Nyeri. That is a challenge I'm giving to you. Message to the graduates. I want to congratulate you, young people. By choosing TVET, you chose it right. And I want to assure you that this nation, the entire world, is looking at TVET to transform the world. The Bible says money answered all things. You can mark that word, answered all things. And it says again, money is a source of all evils. I want to tell you, you will go out there. We are praying for you, you will get jobs. It is very nice to have money. Don't allow that money to destroy you. Use it as a springboard to set higher standards for yourself and also be an ambassador, ambassadors for our TVET institutions in this country. One of the speakers has talked about our youth at home. We have so many people, including our relatives, who knows nothing about TVET. We are asking you to be our ambassadors. When you live here, ensure you pass a message to your affiliates. Tell them TVET is where to be and it is where to go. We are looking forward to see you be part of TVET family and TVET team to see TVET grow. Lastly, I want to thank you, Madam Guest of Honor. You know, our chief guest is one person who is also hands-on and is very committed to transforming TVET. And that is why you will find her every time you invite to your institutions. She's always readily available to commit and attend to your issues. Lastly, some of you are wondering why I was a county commissioner and then all of a sudden I am called secretary of administration. I want to assure you that the work that I'm doing in the ministry is more or less the same work I'm doing, the work I have been doing in the county, in the field, is more or less the same work I'm doing in the ministry. When you come to the ministry and you don't find the peers, the next person you will find is me. Because I do most of the work for her, especially administrative matters. Lastly, I want to encourage the county commissioner and the security team. This institution depends on you. Kindly work very closely with the principal, work very closely with this institution to ensure that this place is secure. Government has invested so much in this institution, and it requires a lot of security. Kindly work closely with the administration. With those few remarks, guest of honor, may I end there. Thank you very much, and God bless you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. I wish to introduce my security team now that you have met on them. Men of Standing. That is the team that I work with. Mr. Apuga, the one who is putting on the kofia now, is in charge of SIPU. Mr. Kuria is my OSPD, sub-county police commander. Mr. Gashero is in charge of investigation. Thank you, you can sit. Thank you very much. As it has been said, much because of the interest of time, I want to thank the the principal for this college. Our chief guest, if you go and tell the CS himself, one thing he will tell you is that he has been very much impressed by the work of a principal. Because I was with him here, and he personally told me that. And when here in Nyeri, the last thing he tells me is that pass through this college, because he really appreciates the good work that the principal has done. It has never been done before. If you come to this institution, now looks so good. Some institution, you go to Nasisha Kenya, Nyeri, Nasis, they were started a long time ago, 70s, but they got to the level of this institution. So keep up. Sikuwe, mwema kisifiwa, temba hulitia maji. Kusiweke maji kwa hiyo pope. Secondly, I want to assure chief guest that we provide adequate security to this institution. There is no way there has been a lapse of security. Even when we were hit hard by the COVID-19, I came here, we discussed with the principal how to implement the protocols which they were observed, and I'm happy I did not hear any death related to COVID in this institution. So I thank you because you were able to situate that all the protocols that we agreed with you were observed. And now to the student, I'm so happy of you. And this is almost my third year in this sub-county. I've never been caught at any one time to bring GSU here with the tear gas, because on vehicles, the road. Never. What I can say is that we deal here with very disciplined students. Can you clap for yourself? Even on very small issues that we hear outside here. Whenever I call your principal, and if it was a small lapse, it is rectified very, very quickly. Thank you very much for that. Now that you have graduated, let me tell you, in our offices there at the headquarters, there's a lot of heart for the youth. I've heard my colleague say, you'll be employed, you get money, you do the this and that. But now I'm challenging you, don't fix your mind on employment, create employment. You have been trained. There is a cousin of mine who actually was in this institution sometimes back, did some electrical things. Right now I think he can challenge me in terms of wealth. Because he started, by the way, he started installation of electricity. Sahi anaitwa kila mahali. Kiona nyumba yenye kijana huyo amejenga. Alienda akaweka kabiashara ya stima pare. Naitwa nini hapa Nairobi town. Kuna uzo vitu nyamakima hapo. Hiyo lifa road hiyo. Everywhere. Naitwa kuweka stima. Please create employment. Don't go sit back. Wait for miracle to happen so that you are employed. The government has set aside a lot of funds for the youths. You come see me, especially those who come from Nyeri. I will introduce you to the officers concerned. You get some loan, you start your business. Please. You start your business, you will also be able to employ some people. You create employment. And that is the Kenya we are today. We are no longer graduating to collar jobs. We are graduating to be creative, to create employment, to employ ourselves and help others. Is that so? The letter once you graduate. So I want to challenge those who are behind you, because I know they are watching. I'm told they're streaming live. Please, the way these students have been disciplined, even you who are behind them, all the sweet. You don't want to solve issues, to bring GSU, to chase you with the tear gas. Okay? That discipline that has been maintained by these ones, those who are graduating even those who are behind, please use the same footsteps. I don't want to speak much. Right now, I want us to prepare our claps so that we invite our chief guest, Dr. Margaret Mwakima, to give us keynote address. 1, 2, 3.
And DCC, for confirming to us that the Nyeri National Polytechnic, you're providing the security that is supposed to be provided for both our institution as well as our trainers and our trainees. So I want to appreciate you together with your security team. The chairman of Nyeri National Polytechnic, together with your council members, the principal Nyeri National Polytechnic, Madam Esther Maina, the secretary administration, Mr. David Kipkemoi, the senior DCC Nyeri Central, Mr. Joseph Mwangi, the CATI principals present, the members of the academic and non-academic team of the Nyeri National Polytechnic, those of you who've come with me from the ministry, the representative of the DTE and the county director, distinguished guests, parents and guardians, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am glad to join you and the Nyeri National Polytechnic community in marking the third graduation ceremony since it became a national polytechnic. And I want to join the rest to congratulate Madam Chief Principal for the beauty, the decor, and the professionalism that we are seeing around this National Polytechnic. And just like the Secretary of Administration said, I think it's one of these institutions that many of our principals should also emulate, because this is the kind of beauty, this is the kind of keeping, and this is the kind of look that we'd like to see in all our TVET institutions countrywide. My appreciation also goes to the graduates for working hard during their training period. The skill set you have acquired are actually the fruits of your hard work. And for us in TVET, we are actually saying, come to our TVET institutions and acquire a skill, build yourself, and build the nation. I also want to appreciate the entertainment team for entertaining us this morning. And from my own self, I want to contribute about 10,000 to them. Shall we hand over to Madam Chief Principal, just to encourage our trainees that any skill you acquire, including the Momboko dance, is part of TVET, because culture, entertainment, animations, and all that we do are using the hands, the feet, is a skill, and it can be able to propagate you to the next level. So thank you, the Momboko team, for entertaining us this morning. I believe it all made us relax and a bit more vibrant this morning. I truly acknowledge with appreciation the role of parents and guardians in supporting the graduates while undergoing training. The best reward you graduates can actually give to your parents or your guardians is to offer exemplary service to the industry and society. And we also want to encourage you as much, because that is what we have prepared you for, to employ yourselves and employ others. I know one of the drawbacks you probably could be having is to do with startup kits and also to do with microfinancing to be able to finance your production. But I also wish to inform that we are now having discussions at very advanced stages so that our support for training will not just only be for tuition, but will also be to support you to be able to get startup kits upon graduation and link you to microfinancing so that we can be able to bridge the unemployment gap amongst our youth. And I think that's something progressive, and we need a clap for that. We are not believing that it will ever happen. We are discussing at very advanced stage because for us to be able to have our youth have to get employment is when we can get them a skill and then allow them to set up their own businesses and in the process employ themselves and employ others. So we are very committed to that, and the discussions we could already have concluded, but we are a bit late for this financial year, but we believe the next financial year we should be able to reach there. We could not be here celebrating attainments of knowledge and skills acquisitions without the commitments of the Governing Council. And looking at the progress that is being made within this National Polytechnic, I wish to acknowledge that the Governing Council is on the right track in terms of the corporate responsibility that they have on governance and integrity, and in terms of attaining the vision for the Polytechnic. So congratulations, Bwana Chair, together with your council. Again, Madam Principal, and given what Madam Principal has done, and the discussions that we are having at the ministry, I think she serves as a good example to showcase that our TVET trainers, including our principals, should be retiring at later ages than what has been prescribed. Look at her. I believe this is the time that she has the strength, she has the experience, the commitment and the dedication to be able now to give her whole self to our TVET reforms and our TVET activities. Sit down, madam, but I think you have seen her. And last week, we began a discussion and would like to progress it to the Public Service Commission that our TVET trainers and together with our principals should actually be retiring when they are 65 years. I know probably some people will think maybe we'll probably disadvantage the youth, but what we are saying, you know, once such a skill is acquired, especially because as we are skill-based, it's made sharper with experience and with time. And if it is happening at Kenya Technical Trainers Colleges, why not at TVET institutions? So this is what we want to progress as early as either this week or next week, And we are hoping that the Public Service Commission will be able to support us in this. After all, we also have not recruited for a while, and so again, we cannot afford to be losing these skills, and yet we are also not recruiting. So rally around me along that, so that we progress this agenda, because our principals are still very youthful. If you look at them, whichever age they look, they are very youthful, again, because they are running around and ensuring that the skills have been imparted. We also are trying also to discuss, because most of these principals, like you are seeing them, a number of them are running institutions with students over 10,000, 12,000, 16,000, comparatively to other institutions in other ministries that are running students of about, having students about 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, and they're at the director level. We also want to, we already have done such a discussion with the Public Service Commission, but we also are presenting another discussion with them so that our principals, especially those who are running institutions of more than 5,000 trainers, should actually be given the position of directors. Probably we might find favor and get to a lesser level, but that is what we wish to discuss with the Public Service Commission on, and they rightly deserve it. The programs, some of you as principals, you are running programs of over 100 programs. Some of you at even 150 programs in one institution. So this we shall progress, and I believe Public Service Commission is hearing us, and we are coming, because we also want our principals to be encouraged and also to continue with the dedication and commitment. We also want to celebrate our academic and non-academic staff, and I wish to appreciate your patience that you have always had with us. We have been promoting you, and we'll continue promoting. Of course, we'll finalize some within this supplementary one. And we wish also to do better as we go to the next financial year. But I also want to reassure the council, together with the rest of the council and board of governors in other TVET institutions, that we also are committed to also recruit other trainers. The Public Service Commission has allowed us to recruit 3,000, and beginning next financial year, we shall begin with recruiting at least 1,000. For those of you who are employee of the council and the BOGs, I believe that time your experience will also be appreciated as we are recruiting going forward. All in general, we are trying to make reforms as far as our HR issues within the TVET institutions is concerned, and we believe when we reach there, then we'll be able to have our TVET institutions more stable, and our trainers and our trainees more encouraged. For the graduates, I also want to appreciate your determination, dedication, and hard work. And also to encourage you that every time you work hard and you work smart, it will always be appreciated. It will never go unnoticed. So as you go out there in the field, work very hard, work very smart, give it out to your best, be the role models and the ambassadors for TVET. Let's build our nation and let us help this nation to industrialize and to get into the manufacturing economy as it's been envisioned in Vision 2030. We are very confident that the curriculum that we have developed, which you have been trained, and the skills that have been imparted to you will be able to inform the building of this nation and making it more prosperous. So I just want to congratulate you all and wish you the very best in your endeavors, and pass a message of goodwill from our Cabinet Secretary, Professor George Magoha, to you, encouraging you to go out there and give your best. I think it's important to receive that congratulatory message. Ladies and gentlemen, globally, TVET has become critical in achieving rapid economic growth, social and technological improvements. This is necessary since human resources require greater technical skills to participate in the knowledge economy. The government is investing much resources in modernizing and expanding technical and vocational institutions, and it is expected that we'll be able to meet the human resource needs of the industry and equip institutions with modern training equipment that match the dynamic industry. In view of this, the government would like to see the national polytechnics, the technical training institutes, the technical and vocational colleges churn out the much needed skilled human labor that meet industry requirements and also ascribe to international recognition. And to this end, we are also at the ministry finalizing discussions for us to be able to elevate 9 of our TVET institutions into national polytechnics. We are at the level of discussions with the Office of the Attorney General, and from there then we shall roll out this reform to be able to increase our national polytechnics, which are standing currently at, I believe, 13, including Kenya Technical Trainers College, to now 22 nationally. I think that's a good achievement. When you ask principals of national polytechnics, they'll be able to tell you the advantage of having an institution as a national polytechnic. So for us to be able to roll out 9 within this particular time that we are in, and to want to get them distributed in a more diverse way as possible it could be across the country, it is not going to be a mean achievement. Again, in terms of investing in our TVET institution, the government has increased the TVET institutions from 52 in 2013 to 238 in 2022. And this has costed the Jubilee government Kenya shillings 10.6 billion. Out of the 238 TVET institutions, 192 are operational and 46 are nearing completion. And due to the 10.3 billion capitation government grants and 11.1 billion head loans to TVET trainees since 2019. There's also been an increase in enrollment from 55,945 in 2013 to 249,316 in 2022. Additionally, the Jubilee government has also been granting Kenya shillings 2 billion to counties towards ensuring that we have the standards and the quality assurance improved within the national policy framework. So therefore, what I'm actually saying is that since the Jubilee government took position in 2013, they have built institutions to an investment of 10.6 billion. They have equipped these institutions to a tune of about 20.5 billion. So that's already how much? For those of you who are doing mathematics, 10.6 plus 10.5? 30? 31.1 billion. Then we have also given 10.3 billion capitation grant. That's additional from 31.1. 4.3. And then we have also given, since 2019, 11.1 billion of HELB loans. So in total, the total investment is how much? Those of you who are doing mathematics. 55.4 billion. So that is the commitment that the Jubilee government has had since inception in 2013 to ensure that our TVET institutions are accessible, there is equity, and we are able to get our enrollment higher. In fact, if you get to our TVET institutions, you'll find that we have equipped most of them, over 190, with the state-of-the-art equipment. And plans are underway for us to also equip the remaining. And in addition, we have also paid about 150 million to the Ministry of Energy to be able to connect our TVET institutions with the three-phase power, so that the equipments that we have invested can be able to be used for the training purposes that it is meant to have. Beginning of this financial year, this 2 billion grant that we've been giving directly from the ministry to the county is now getting into them through the equalization fund. And we want to urge the county government to prioritize the utilization of these funds to improve the standards and the quality of the VTCs, because the youth of the county and the youth of the national government, there is no difference. They are all the Kenyan youth. So apart from equipping these institutions with the state-of-the-art equipment, we have also been ensuring that our trainers are capacity built. They get to be trained every time and again, so that they can be improving and not only being trained nationally, but also internationally. A number of them have gone to Germany for training, others are in Canada, others will also be going to various parts within the EU. And in addition, we also have 4 special needs TVET. And given that there's a lot of investment that has gone on in early learning and basic on special needs, we're also trying as much to prepare for the special needs as they go into 100% transition within our TVET. So in view of this, we are now partnering with the Canadian government and a number of, I think, Italy institutions in Italy and the Netherlands to be able to benchmark and see how we can be able to improve on our special needs training. So within next month, we shall have some trainers from special needs TVETs visiting Canada, Italy, Netherlands, and I believe one more country, so that again we can improve on our special needs TVET. Because we are committed to access, to ensuring there is access, and there is also equity. Ladies and gentlemen, there is need to train a critical mass of technologists, technicians, and artisans in TVET institutions to be able to achieve aspirations in socioeconomic growth in the country. Therefore, TVET institutions are expected to design demand-driven programs to be able to bridge identified skill gaps in the diverse fields. In view of this, we are now finalizing on the dual training policy or the cooperative training policy so that we can have a 50-50 training engagement between our institutions and the industry. And this, I believe, will not only make us to be at par with the industry, but it also ensure to some extent that we are ahead of them. I note with satisfaction that the Nyeri National Polytechnic has been collaborating and engaging with the private sector at various levels to increase its quality and relevance through apprenticeship, internships, and on-the-job training. Through partnership and collaboration with colleges and Institutes Canada, SICAN, the Nyeri National Polytechnic has built a dairy processing workshop at a cost of Kenya shillings 50 million, while the partners equipped the facility with a state-of-the-art dairy processing and quality assurance equipment worth over 50 million. So this is an additional 100 million that has been invested to the Nyeri National Polytechnic within its catchment area of beef and dairy production. Ladies and gentlemen, the number of trainees graduating from TVET institutions has been steadily on the increase. I note with gratification that today, Nyeri National Polytechnic is releasing 2,853 graduates in diverse disciplines that are necessary for sustainable development, achievement of the Big Four agenda, and the Kenya Vision 2030. A big applause to Nyeri National Polytechnic. We are all too aware that TVET graduates enter into a globally competitive labor market, and for this reason, I urge all national polytechnics to benchmark, collaborate, and partner with other top institutions in the world. Such collaborations will result in internationally recognized programs that are relevant to both local and international labor markets. Additionally, TVET institutions should endeavor to ensure that courses offered equip trainees with entrepreneurial skills to establish their own businesses upon completion. This will, in no doubt, go a long way in creating employment opportunities in line with the Big Four agenda. Ladies and gentlemen, quality training is a mirage without proper equipment and personnel. We want TVET institutions to provide an industrial level experience for both the trainers, the trainees, and the industry requirements. In this regard, the government has provided ultra-modern level equipment for training in most of our institutions, and TVETs are urged to involve the industry players, to involve the alumni in development of the courses offered. As we move to CBET, ladies and gentlemen, we want to tell Kenyans that as TVET, we are ready to train the CBC as they get from the early learning and basic. We have trained all our trainers at Kenya Technical Trainers College, and we are continuously training them. As it is, even today, we are graduating some of our CBET, some of our graduates who have gone through the CBET courses, and therefore we are waiting to be able to further equip our graduates with the right experience, the right skills, and the right attitudes for them to inform the industry, which is an integral part of the socioeconomic growth of this country. I also want to applaud the industry players for their continued support in accepting our TVET trainees in their establishments through attachments and internships. Ladies and gentlemen, Vision 2030 envisions Kenya as an industrialized middle-income country that will be able to provide high quality of life to all her citizens, and who will live in a clean and secure environment by the year 2030. We are not far off from that time, and we need to move as TVET even faster so that we can be able to provide the technicians and the technologists that will be able to realize the vision. And in view of this, you graduates of today are actually part of the people who will catalyze the realization of Vision 2030 and make it happen. You are the reason why the government shall continue to fund the construction and equipping of modern workshops and laboratories in STEM-related courses. Thus, the TVET institutions are also expected to impart topmost notch training experience for trainees for the vision to be actualized. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the energy, the skill, and the resilience of artisans, technicians, and technologists who made the Industrial Revolution possible. The fourth Industrial Revolution we are going through still requires artisans, technologists, and technicians. To the graduates, the ceremony symbolizes your academic pursuit. It is also a moment to look back at what you have achieved in the academic journey. Remember, the society will judge you based on quality of your service, integrity, and ethical behavior. On this note, I urge you to seize every opportunity to offer the best service to mankind so that we can transform the livelihoods of our people. And I also want to offer hope to you, because as TVET, we want to make it a pathway for your academic aspirations, and also to offer hope and to restore dignity to our TVET institutions we want to inform the youth that we now have finalized various pathways for you to be able to move through our TVET system up to the first degree, up to the second degree, the third degree, and acquire your PhDs and become professors, so long as you always have aspired. We have now concluded the pathway for agriculture through Kenya National Qualifications Authority. We are working on the one for tourism and hospitality, and we also have challenged Kenya National Qualification Authority to ensure that this financial year they should not only conclude the one for tourism and hospitality, but try their best to conclude two more. So that as a youth in this country, you can join TVET at class 8 after class 8 and leave your aspirations to the highest levels of the academic ladder. You can also join our TVET institutions at Form 4 level and still leave your aspirations up the academic ladder while providing skills, but also moving to levels of policy and strategy. Ladies and gentlemen, as I conclude, I wish to thank the parents, the guardians, and sponsors for investing in the lives of these young men and women graduating today. I highly commend the national government through CUSPS and HELP for allocating funds for the trainees in support of their education. I also wish to appreciate both our academic and non-academic staff for their dedication, commitment, and resilience in ensuring that our graduates and those who are being trained are acquiring the prerequisite skills for the industry. I also want to appreciate the county governments for awarding needy trainees bursaries to ensure they achieve their educational aspirations. I want to thank the various industry players that have allowed our trainees to practice the knowledge through industrial attachment and hardships. Thank you all. Thank you, Nyeri National Polytechnic. And finally, for all of us here and elsewhere, let us give Nyeri National Polytechnic a chance to become a premium technical training institute that responds to industry needs. May God bless Kenya and may God bless us all.
The guest of honor, Madam Pierce, please allow me to call the following heads of departments to present their respective graduates who were examined and certified for the Award of Artisan and Craft Certificate for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021 in the following order: Applied Science, Automotive Engineering, Building and Civil Engineering, Business Studies, Computer Science and Networking, Electrical and Electronic Engineering, Fashion Design and Beauty Therapy, Hospitality and Tourism, Liberal Studies, Mechanical Engineering. Graduates, kindly stand up once your name is called or your course is called, and remain standing until all the departments are read and until the certificates are awarded.
The guest of honor, Madam Pierre, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of craft certificate for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Next, certificate in Science Laboratory Technology, 8 graduates. Certificate in Food Processing and Preservation, 24. Thank you.
the guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for the award of craft and artisan and craft certificates for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. NITA, Motor Vehicle Mechanics Grade 3, 34 graduates. Motor Vehicle Mechanics Grade 2, 10. Motor Vehicle Electrician Grade 3, 20. Plant Mechanics Grade 3, 9. Plant Mechanics Grade 2, 1. NEC, Artisan in Motor Vehicle Mechanics, 29. Craft Certificate in Agriculture Mechanics, 3. That is 6. Craft Certificate in Construction Plant Maintenance, 8. Thank you.
Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of artisan and craft certificates for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Plumbing level 3, 16 graduates. Masonry level 3, 1. Masonry grade 3, 22. Masonry grade 2, 2. Masonry grade 1, 1. Carpentry and joinery grade 3, 2. Plumber pipe fitter grade 3, 83. Plumber pipe fitter grade 2, 7. Plumber pipe fitter grade 1, 1. Neck, artisan plumbing, 6. Clerk certificate in building technology, 84. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of artisan craft certificates for the year 2019, 2020, and 2021. NEC, craft certificate in secretarial studies, 1. Teacher, Minor Kennedy Jogona, craft certificate in business management, 30. Craft certificate in human resource management, 17. Craft certificate in corporate management, 3. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of artisan and craft certificates for the years 2019, 2020, 2021. Computer Science and Networking Department, CNA 50, ICDL, International Certificate of Digital Literacy, 80, NEC, Craft Certificate in Information Communication Technology, 50, Distinction, Moreidi Anthony Jero, Dicho Chemeri Ruth. Thank you.
Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of artisan and craft certificate for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. CDAC, Electrical Installation Level 3, 4. Simple Automation Level 4, 14. NITA, Electrical Wireman Grade 3, 163. Electrical Wireman Grade 2, 40. Electrical Wireman Grade 1, 11. Electrical Fitters Grade 3, 1. Solar Photovoltaic Grade 3, 22. NEC, Craft Certificate in Electrical Engineering, 79. Thank you.
Hairdressing Grade 3, 66 graduates. Hairdressing Grade 2, 11 graduates, interesting grade 1, 1, Utelelate grade 3, 64, Utelelate grade 2, 10, Utelelate grade 1, 1, Tiraring grade 3, 1, Tiraring grade 2, 1, Dressmaking grade 2, 1, NEC, Certificate in Arts and in Garment Making, 30, Craft Certificate in Fashion Design and Garment Making, 110. Distinction, Mumanyi Enoch Bonyi, Wapocho Grades Warogoro, Wawero Susan Wangari. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduate who are examined and certified for award of artisan and craft certificate for the year 2019, 2020, and 2021. TVET SIDAC, Food and Beverage Culinary Art Level 3, Graduate 3. NEC, Artisan in Food and Beverage 116, Certificate in Food and Beverage, 98. Distinction, Kiprono Niklin Rotich. Certificate in Catering and Accommodation, 237. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for the award of craft certificates for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. 5, 1 graduate. NEC, Certificate in Social Work and Community Development, 28. Craft Certificate in Information Studies, 13. Thank you.
P.S., please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of artisan and craft certificates for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. TVET SIDA, Manual Metal Arc Welding Level 4, 18 graduates. Lathe Machine Operator Level 4, 20. NITA, Welder Electrical Grade 3, 10. Welder, Electrical Grade 2, 1. NEC, Certificate in Mechanical Engineering, 9. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I now call upon the chief guest to award the certificates.
In accordance to the TVET Act, number 29 of 2013, and the Nyeri National Polytechnic Order number 91 of 2016, I award you the certificates for which you have been examined and certified accordingly. Congratulations.
Thank you. Honor, Madam PS, please allow me to call the following heads of departments to present their respective graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021 in the following order: Applied Science, Automotive Engineering, Building and Civil Engineering, Business Studies, Computer Science and Networking, Electrical and Electronic Engineering, Fashion Design and Beauty Therapy, Health Sciences, Hospitality and Tourism, Liberal Studies, Mechanical Engineering. Graduates, kindly stand up when you hear your name and remain standing until all the departments are read out and until your diplomas or the diplomas are awarded. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021.
Credit: Kamau, Karioki, Kemani, Kenyanjui, Kiorio, Kirago, Mogo, Pat, Chegen, Gedendi, Getweku, Kagwe, Kamau, Kamunya, Karioki Anne, Karioki Diana, Karoga, Kenywa, Honyu, Masharia Lisa, Masharia N, Mararo, Matenge, Miroki, Mongari, Mushira, Mogo, Muitia, Mukami, Munene Jackson, Munene Judy, Murage, Moai, Mwangi, Mwaniki, Nganga, Gari, Gudiru, Jaramba, Njiru, Jogona, Nyambura, Timwa, Piongo, Wamaida, Wanjiro Gladys, Wanjiro Jay, Wanjohi, Wanjohi, Wanyeki. Diploma in Applied Biology: Pass, Raki, Karundo, Kinywa, Maina Lilian, Maina Phineas, Murage, Domu, Jagi, Jaguara, Jerry, Jogona, Ntaragwe, Nyokapi, Newton, Toita. Diploma in Analytical Chemistry: Freddy, Kamande, Pass, Gashiengo, Gakure, Kahuho, Karioki, Mumani, Musau, Mwangi, Mwati, Nanyama, Gige, Wangari. Diploma in Environmental Science: Pass, Matenge, Maungu, Omondi, Wambua. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam T.S., please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Credit: Githari, Kironyo, Uzua, Moiruri, Mwangi, Mohia, Nganga, Jogona, Joki, Wanjao, Waweru, Paz, Karanja, Kemani, Kipruto, Manje, Matu, Miano, Mogo, Moragori, Moremi, Modhi, Daruga, Joroge G, Joroge Rafael, Joroge Virginia, Deuri, Wagura, Wamboi. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in Building Technology: Credit, Gaikia, Kagwe, Kamau, Kamotho, Karumba, Gehuro, Kome, Masharia, Maina, Munene, Mureithi, Mutuma, Dungu, Gasha, Wagoi. Pass: Gatonye, Kabuli, Kalemi, Kimugu, Macharia, Mulivi Donald, Mulivi Munene, Muliuki, Mudhi, Mutuli, Gatia, Jogu, Nyamwitha, Wacheke, Wailimo, Waweru. Diploma in Civil Engineering, Credit. Irongo, Kabea, Kamau, Kaliuki, Misheni, Mohamed, Mulaya, Muligo, Mwagi Anthony, Mwagi Frida, Giangui, Nyaga, Wagoi, Wajiro, Wajoke, Pass, Etian, Kihoyo, Kimani, Maina, Maina Kevin, Maina Dennis, Bogo, Megwe, Mobi, Munyi, Mwai, Mwagi Gakenia, Mwagi Simon, Mwaniki, Mwigirwa, Delito, Goge, Nyaga, Nyagothie, Nyoto, Lukwano, Sawe, Wakene, Wango. Thank you.
Guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in accountancy, credit, Gidaiga, Kanywa, Kinyari, Lesepe, Mwaniki Kenneth, Mwaniki Wanjiru, Matenge, Matiki, Mbugwa, Muchoki, Muhoro, Mureu, Murioki Benjamin, Murioki Ruth, Murumbi, Mutua, Mutueri, Murioki Mwangi, Mwangi Valentine, Mwikari, Dungu, Nanga, Joroge, Onyango, Sarato, Washera, Wamboi, Wangoi, Wanjohi, Wanyoiki, Paz, Gitao, Kinywa, Maina, Bishuki, Mumbe, Mureithi Kreo, Mureithi Eric, Musau, Mwangi, Joroge, Nyambura, Dawid, Nyambura Grace, Wamushi, Wanjiru. Diploma in Sales and Marketing, Credit, Marine. Diploma in Supply Chain Management, Distinction, Kihara, Ngatha, Tabitha, Nganga, Ruse, Wangeshi, Wanja, Esther, Gema. Credit, Alasa, Boimi, Chege, Ichigo, Ichohe, Ikundi, Gedenji, Idoi, Ihure, Ireri, Jeragat, Juma, Kabata, Kamau, Kamori, Kariuki Esther, Kariuki Tabitha, Karuri, Karuero, Kibara, Kirugumi, Ombe, Maina Caroline, Maina Corinth, Maina Harriet, Maina Mary, Maina Morini, Madagania, Mbae, Batia, Mbogo, Mboro, Mengo, Megwe, Mugo Diana, Mugo Kendi, Muhoro, Ukeli, Murage, Ureili, Usioka, Udike, Udoga, Udoni, Uduko, Mwai, Mwangi Abisa, Mwangi Esther, Mwangi Margaret, Mwangi Mwasi, Mwangi Wateri, Mwiti, Ndegwa, Derito, Nduru, Duta, Ngai, Nganga, Ngari, Ngatia, Godo, Jenga, Ndugi, Nyutu, Ochodo, Otiambo, Oduom, Ojian, Teuri, Duo, Uranera, Wachira, Kelvin, Wachira Esther, Wairimu, Waidera, Wakarema, Wambugu, Wamboi, Wangeshi, Wangoi, Wanjiku, Wanjera, Wajohi, Waweru Frida, Waweru Margaret, Winnie, Paz, Maina, Makena, Boru, Mirengo, Joroge. Diploma in Business Management, Credit, Gichuki, Gitahi, Kariuki, Uria, Maina Mary, Maina Mwangi, Maina Wamboi, Mwiruri, Florence, Moreiri, Mudami, Mwangi, Dirango, Wahome, Pass, Kirene, Moreiri, Mwai, Mwangi, Dirango, Jerry, Juki, Rito, Wachanga, Wachira, Wairimi,
Diploma in Corporate Management, Credit, Fundi, Kakenia, Itahi, Ideiki, Kanja, Karemi, Kibara, Kihara, Kihiko, Kimaki, Kimoto, Kingori Julian, Kingori Severina, Kinywa, Kidua, Macharia, Maina, Muchira, Mukami, Mureili, Mutembei, Mudoi, Mutua, Muturi, Mwangi An, Mwangi Winfred, Mwenje, Dabiri, Daruga, Delta, Derito, Garachi, Jagi, Jaramba, Joseph, Jaramba, Mwangi, Jel, Juguna, Paz, Cheve, Cheviot, Ichohi, Idure, Irimba, Matenge, Ugera, Mwini, Mureili, Mwangi, Rutere, Wairimu, Wamugi, Wangoi. Diploma in Human Resource Management, Credit, Busben, Etiani, Gavi, Giavi, Gidaiga, Kamindo, Kariuki Esther, Kariuki Joan, Kidome, Macharia, Maena, Masika, Matu, Moreidi Christine, Moreidi Tabitha, Uthama, Mudoni, Muduma, Mwangi, Mwihaki, Naivesti, Duruhi, Ngigi, Njoki, Nyagudhie, Wabukira, Washera, Wambugu, Wanjiku, Wanjiro Caroline, Wanjiro Vishuru, Waweri, Pass. Diploma in Project Management, Credit, Lumumba Party. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, 2021. Computer Science and Networking Department, Diploma in Information Communication Technology, Distinction, Molei Alex Malonza, Credit, Kabwere, Kagai, Kangede, Orioki, Musau, Mwai, Mwangi Catherine, Mwangi Evelyn, Mwangi Kiai, Mwangi Masi, Mwirigi, Derito, Dongo, Gatia, Goge Bildad, Goge Zipora, Gojiri, Jerry, Nyagaki, Ochieng, Theuri, Diongo, Waiderero, Wambiro, Wambogo, Wangondu, Wangeshi, Wajohi, Waroe, Wawero, Wawera. Pass. Katofo, Mumo, Mutua, Jogona, Wanjohi. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in Electrical Engineering. Credit, Kamau, Madenge, Mureidi, Njoroge, Wairimo, Wanjohi. Pass, Chelagat, Gaido, Gitari, Kamunya, Kaunyangi, Kiprono, Kuria, Masharia, Maina Karioki, Maina Moses, Maina Nerito, Mugo, Murioki, Mutahi, Mwangi Njori, Mwangi Kidua, Ndicho, Ndongo, Ngatia, Njeri, Nyagi, Ogol, Tiongo, Tuku, Washira, Wambogo, Wanja, Wanjiko, Wanjohi Ndirango, Wanjohi Ngima. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who were examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in Fashion Design and Clothing Technology. Credit, Getala, Isema, Getonga, Getuko, Kamau, Kamotho, Karioki, Chego, Maina, Mutala, Moshiri, Mwangi Clementine, Mwangi Faith, Mwangi Sisle, Diangui, Nyeri, Jeri, Jiro, Jogona, Waihio, Waivera, Wamarwa,
Wabogo, Wamoyo, Wajogo, Pas, Gideji, Kebiri, Maina, Uringe, Mwangi, Nganga, Jao. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam Piers, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Health Science Department, Diploma in Pharmaceutical Technology. Distinction, Guru K. Samuel. Credit, Yidaiga, Yidinchi, Karaya, Kirungumi, Pass. Kamau, Nkangara, Kariuki, Karoi, Masharia, Bogo, Mushiri, Mwangi, Dewa, Dirangu, Gari, Chora, Juguna, Odira, Washira. Thank you.
Please allow me to present the following graduate who were examined and certified for award of diploma for the year 2019-2020 and 2021. Diploma in Food and Beverage Management. Credit. Mwagi Wodhaya, Gethe, Gare, Gatia, Joki, Prisira, Thoithi, Washira. Pass. Chege, Gadigia, Gitoga, Kadare, Maina, Mogo, Murioki, Morogo, Mwaneki, Duta, Gare, Jogu, Salim, Waihoni, Wajiro. Diploma in Catering and Accommodation. Credit. Aruk, Ayasa, Furugo, Gishoge, Gishoke, Gishoro, Gwadina, Haiza, Hyoho, Japchuba, Kagweria, Kahia, Kamami, Kamau, Kaunyangi, Kazira, Kibe, Kemani, Kemingi, Kengori, Kenywa Michael, Kenywa Morin, Kipkogei, Kiplangat, Kipnyetich, Kipsang, Kisengese, Maigwa, Maina Anastasia, Maina Lucy, Maina Mirka, Maina Regina, Mainge, Makidi, Maswi, Madenge, Mauti, Biruani, Boga, Bogwa, Mogesi, Molanga, Mushoki, Mugambi, Mogo, Muinde, Mumari, Mombi, Monohe, Murage, Muraya, Mureithi, Murioki, Mude, Mutugi, Muturi, Mwangi Isabella, Mwangi Karioki, Mwangi Margaret, Mwangi Nance, Mwangi Ruth, Muihaki, Degi, Denga, Dereba, Dirango David, Dirango Duta, Dirango Joseph, Dubi, Digirigi, Goge Halon, Goge Mere, Gubi, Guyo, Juye, Jogona Ajera, Jogona John, Odhiambo, Ogali, Okinda, Onyango, Duo, Washira, Wabogo, Waboi Mwehaki, Waboi Sandra, Waboi Ted, Wabura, Wamete, Wajiro, Wajohi Faith, Wajohi Mere, Wanyeki, Wawero, Wawire. Pass. Charo, Gadoni, Gikangi, Gitau, Kamura, Kangede, Kanyi, Karuaya, Kiage, Kihiro, Kunga, Masharia Nyabura, Masharia Mine, Masharia Wagoi, Maina Jakri, Maina Wangale, Mogwe, Muhusin, Muirore, Muhwana, Murage, Mureithi, Murioki, Musau, Musera, Mutegi, Muturi, Mwario, Derito, Dongo, Jerry, Jiro, Joki Yunes, Joki James, Nyabura, Nyogesa, Odusu, Onsogo, Otemo, Otieno Omaiko, Otieno Steven, Theuri, Washira, Wafura, Wairimo, Wabogo, Wamosha, Wanja, Wajiro, Wajohi, Wanyonyi, Wekesa. Diploma in Tourism Management.
distinction. Madipo, Aive, Wamahiga, Ogora, and Akinyi, Duo, J, Kairori. Credit. Shege, Geshimo, Gedeji, Huja, Ireri, Kagoda, Karioki, Kero, Kirago, Maina Nyaroi, Maina Pita, Bogo, Mushiri, Mushoi, Mombi, Mwangi, Mudai, Namulei, Jage, Joroge, Jogona Helen, Jogona Teresia, Ogaga, Washira, Waigwa, Wangare, Wagoi, Wajohi. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in Social Work and Community Development, Distinction, Aoko Mary, Chebi K. Joyce, Gedenji Mary Wamboi, Kanyoro Winnie R. Wadiha, Koome Franklin Mudhomi, Maundu J. Mwikali, Mwangi Purity Wanjiko, Ngugi Lili Njoki, Nyaga Liki Kiremi, Opio Atieno Sharon, Wahome Nicholas Maina, Wambura Roda Wanjiko. Credit, Afudo, Gishuru, Hunja, Tafue, Taremi, Kingori, Lopeo, Magode, Mogosi, Munene, Mungedo, Murage, Mudami, Mwai, Mwangi Lois, Mwangi Veronica, Mwaneki, Mwanzia, Mwaora, Nanzala, Diangui, Ndulu, Dungo, Gondi, Njero, Washira, Wamboi, Wamondwe. Pass, Tagiri, Kihara, Wangoi. Diploma in Information Studies, Distinction, Biasha Lela Kemu, Karioki Sharon Muthoni, Kongo Miriam Wanja, Mu Gishoke, Indebe, Itaru, Kafaya, Kamadhi, Kamau Caroline, Kamau Wamahiga, Kamoya, Kanye, Karanja Miriam, Karanja Wamboi, Karioki, Karogo, Kefue, Kioko, Kirichi, Kuria, Lanyasunya, Maina Judy, Maina Margaret, Maku, Mambo, Mbaro, Mbolo, Muirore, Mulonzia, Moraya, Mudike, Mutura, Moya, Mwangi John, Mwangi Peter, Ndegwa, Derito, Dirango Nicholas, Dirango Susan, Derito, Dungo, Gundi, Jake, Jambi, Jero, Jiro, Ndiga, Nyaga Grace, Nyaga Sheila, Nyangao, Dhuku, Wagura, Waheto, Waigwa, Wamboi, Wangai, Wanjiro Lydia, Wanjiro Martha, Wasi, Pass, Gaita, Luvanda, Muturi. Thank you.
The guest of honor, Madam Pierce, please allow me to present the following graduates who are examined and certified for award of diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Diploma in Mechanical Production Option. Credit, Kagunda, Kahudhia, Maingi, Ndishu. Pass, Asango, Danson, Yeshimo, Kago, Maina Harrison, Maina Morris, Malui, Mudondi, Mwangi, Dirango, Ntere, Nyaga, Wanguru. Diploma in Mechanical Plant Option. Credit, Mwangi. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I now wish to kindly request the chief guest to award the diploma.
In accordance to the TVET Act number 29 of 2013 and the Nyeri National Polytechnic Order number 91 of 2016, I award you the diploma for which you have been examined and certified accordingly. Congratulations.
The guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to call the registrar in charge of examinations to present graduates who are examined and certified for the award of higher diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Graduates, kindly stand up and remain upstanding until the higher diploma is awarded.
Guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to present the following two graduates who are examined and certified for award of higher diploma for the years 2019, 2020, and 2021. Higher diploma in construction, building, and civil auction. Credit, Kagagi Wambui Grace. Higher diploma in library and information management, distinction, Nyeri Hilda Mobi.
Thank you very much. I now kindly call the chief guest to confer the higher diploma.
In accordance to the TVET Act number 29 of 2013, and the Nyeri National Polytechnic Order Number 91 of 2016, I award you the higher diploma for which you have been examined and certified accordingly. Congratulations.
The guest of honor, Madam P.S., please allow me to call the Internal Quality Assurance Officer to present exemplary performers for awards.
The guest of honor, Madam PS, please allow me to present the following exemplary performance for awards. Best overall trainee in TVET CEDA qualification, Red Machine Operator Level 4, Mastery, Nicholas Dirango Limuri. I now request Chairperson Kati, Madam Glory Mutugi, to come and present the award. Best overall trainee in TVET Arts and Courses, Kati Mount Kenya Chairman, Mr. Arts and Food and Beverage, Credit Wageshi Daniel Odomi. I now request Kati Mount Kenya Chairman, Mr. Mugambi, to come and present the award. Best overall trainee in TVET Craft Business Courses, Certificate in Information Communication Technology. Distinction, Mulevi Anthony Jero. And I will request a council member, Madam Jane Mugore, to come and present the award. Best overall trainee in TVET Craft Technical Courses, Craft Certificate in Fashion Design and Garment Making, Distinction, Wabutu Gladys Warogoro. I now request a council member, Dr. Muyembe, to come and present the award. Best overall training in TVET Diploma Technical Courses, Diploma in Pharmaceutical Technology, Distinction, Guru K. Samuel. I now request Council Member Dr. Chesalek to come and present the award. Best overall trainee in higher diploma technical courses, higher diploma in construction, building and civil option. Credit, Kagagi Waboi Grace. I now request Director TVET, Madam Jane, to come and present the award. Best overall trainee in higher diploma business courses, higher diploma in library and information management, Distinction, Jerry Hilda Mumbi. I now request Chairman of the Council, Mr. Ekwe, to come and present the award. overall best trainee, diploma in supply chain management, distinction, Wanja Esther Gima. And now request our chief guest come and present the award. Thank you.
Okay, congratulations, graduates. Guest of honor, this time we're going to have another special gift, guest of honor. And I call upon the chief principal and the chairman of the council. Present the award. Thank you for that. Chief guest, ladies and gentlemen, we are coming close to the end of the ceremony. And this time, I call upon Ms. Evelyn Anupi, council member, to pass a vote of thanks. Thank you.
Chief guest, are the principal secretary, State Department for Vocational and Technical Training, Dr. Margaret Mwakima, the county commissioner, senior government officials, the chairperson of the council members, chief principal, county principals present, graduates, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Mine is very simple to pass a word of thanks. This is a beautiful day that the Lord has made. We are here to celebrate you, our graduates, because you have made us proud. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to everyone for coming to witness this important ceremony. This is the graduation of our trainees who are here with us, and some of them are following this function virtually. You have done us proud. We are looking upon you as the future of this country. We want to thank the Almighty God for making this day a success. By His blessings and grace, we are able to make this event as colorful as it has turned out. Congratulations to you all for the great achievement. Your hard work has finally paid off. You have been conferred upon the very much deserved certificates and diplomas, and we want to congratulate you for that. To the parents and guardians, please accept our sincere gratitude. You have been able to support the learners. You have paid their fees. You have worked with them. And I can see quite a number of you who have come to witness this special function. Thank you very much for that support. I also want to thank the trainers, the non-teaching staff, the management of Nyeri National Polytechnic for making this a success. We know that you gave it your very best, and this has made us proud on this particular day. The county commissioner and the security team, thank you very much. We really feel safe when we see you around. And we also know that in your day-to-day duties, you ensure that Nyeri National Polytechnic exists peacefully. Thank you very much. On behalf of the council, I want to sincerely thank our chief guest, that is the principal secretary for the State Department for Vocational and Technical Training. Despite her busy schedule, she has made time to grace this occasion. Madam PS, we have heard your thoughts, your encouraging words, and this definitely puts us at a greater height. Thank you very much for encouraging. Thank you very much for gracing this occasion. We really feel blessed to have you grace this particular occasion. Your thoughts have really enlightened us, and we promise to continue keeping the fire burning so that we ensure Nyeri National Polytechnic achieves greater heights. To all the invited guests, thank you for honoring our invitation and being part of this beautiful day. The police band, we are really grateful. You honored our invitation. You have cheered us, and you have made the day look as good as it is today. Members of the Fourth Estate, thank you very much for finding time to be with us. We know that you've done a beautiful coverage for this beautiful day of ours. Finally, I would like to say thanks to the organizing committee for the perfect logistical arrangements and the planning process that you put in. We know that it requires putting every detail in place, an assignment that you have delivered well to make the day a success. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot thank every one of you enough for making the day a success. What I can say is that God's blessings upon each and every one of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Madam Anupi. This time, Chief Guest, allow me 1 minute to call upon the Chairperson of the Graduation Committee, Madam Leto Kimani, to make one announcement, please. Thank you.
Guest, allow me to make a very short announcement regarding the venues where our guests are going to take their meals. Our Chief Guest and her entourage will be going to the good room after this. Our county principals and all the academic HODs will go to the conference room, and they will be ushered in by Madam Catherine Moshono. Catherine, I ask that you come here so that the guests can see you. That is Madam Catherine Moshono. She will be working with Cheryl Apodi. I am asking them to come in front so that you can see them and be able to follow them as they lead you to the various venues. Then our council members and all the distinguished guests and any overflow from the boardroom will be attended in room A1.2. And A1.2 is on the first floor of our administration building. They will be ushered in by Madam Tabitha Kefodo. Tabitha, please. Any overflow from that room will go to room A1.2, which is just next to A1.1. So A1.1, we are going to be ushered in by Madam Helen Mwangi. Helen Mwangi. So, allow me to repeat, council members, distinguished guests, any overflow from the boardroom will go to room A1.2. Any overflow from room A1.2 will go to room A1.1.
Then we have the police bird who will go to Cafe 1 and they are going to be ushered in by Madam Grace Degwa. Grace Degwa, step forward kindly. Then we have an overflow from a Cafe 1. They will go to Cafe 2, which is just next to Cafe 1. So any police bird members who may not fit in Cafe 1 will go to Cafe 2. And we'll also have the members of the fourth estate in Cafe 2. You are all going to be ushered by Madam Grace Degwa. The Nyeri National Polytechnic staff will be attended in our dining hall. Our dining hall is the largest building after the field, just near where the vehicles are parked. And you'll also, we'll also accommodate there all the drivers that came with our distinguished guest. Thank you very much. Asante.
Okay, thank you, Rachel. That is good information. I see everybody is happy. That's good. So, after the mention, graduate is going to celebrate with your parents. Enjoy the time together. Thank you. So, this time, Madam Pierce, allow me to call the chief principal to dissolve the congregation.
By virtue of the authority vested on me by the TVET Act number 29 of 2013 and the Nyeri National Polytechnic Order number 91 of 2016, I hereby declare this congregation and the proceedings dissolved. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Chief Principal. This time, I want to call upon Council Member, not Council Member this time, it is a trainer, Mrs. Juliana Mwaneki, to come for the closing prayer. Thereafter, we shall have the national anthem. Thank you. Starting from now until we get the anthem. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, it is with a lot of humility and gratitude that we approach your throne of mercy this afternoon. We enter your gate with thanksgiving and your court with praise because of what you have done for us today. I want to thank you that by your grace you have enabled us to go through that tight program and we are on course. This we give glory to you. We want to appreciate you that you brought our chief guest and all her entourage safely to this place. And we appreciate you, Lord, because you gave them tender masses. And we are also praying in the same way, Lord, you shall take her back with her entourage back to her destination. We also want to appreciate you, Lord, for our graduates and their parents. You brought them from every corner of this nation. Safely have they arrived. And we worship you for each one of them. As they enter the world of job, God, they need you. Your word says, you're the Lord that gives us power to create wealth. We pray in Jesus' name that the knowledge, the skill they have acquired, they shall use it, Lord Almighty, to take this nation into great height. Because the nation is eyeing them. The family members are eyeing them. Even us as their trainers, we are eyeing them. And we commend them to you that God Almighty, none of them will be lost. But they shall enter their destiny in you. And you shall align them with your godly agenda. In Jesus' name. We also want to appreciate the entire family of Nyeri Pori. This far above Father, you have brought us. Well, it not for you being on our side, we wouldn't come this far. Therefore, Lord, for every commendation, for every appreciation, for every achievement, we as a family, the management of the institution, the council, and the entire fraternity of Nyeri Polytechnic, this afternoon will return all glory, all honor, and all praises unto you. We also appreciate all other guests that have created this occasion to be with us. It's such an honor. God bless you. We bless them in Jesus' name. Father, as we depart from this place, people are going to travel throughout this country. God Almighty, your word says that you know our coming and going back. We trust you, Abba Father, for journey masses, and we secure your people with the blood of Jesus. God Almighty, bless Nyeri Pori, bless Nyeri County, bless Kenya. In Jesus' name, we pray and give thanks.
Okay, thank you, Madam Juliana. This time we shall have the national anthem followed by the East African anthem. Thereafter, we shall remain studying, continue the guest and her entourage, leave, and we shall follow. Thank you. Thank you.